So how much damage can tubeless tyres take? As road cyclists, we've become more familiar with tubeless tyres and their ability to seal punctures as you ride. But just how much damage can they sustain? What if James Bond was riding away from the baddies and they tried to take out his tyres? Would he be able to survive if he was running tubeless? So to test this, I've set up my bike with tubeless tyres and wheels and filled them full of orange seal sealant. And I've also created a gauntlet of tyre death. It sounds a lot more impressive than what it actually is. I was just up all night hammering nails into a piece of wood. So let's see what happens.
I have no idea if this is actually going to work. Oh, I feel like I'm getting sprayed with sealant.
Oh, is that sealed?
Oh, there's like loads of little holes, look. But that's actually sealed. There's no air coming out. That's ridiculous. That is actually ridiculous.
So, somewhat surprisingly and a little bit disappointingly, the tyres were able to see off my gauntlet of death. So I've decided to up the stakes and make the gauntlet of death even more deadly.
You got this. I've always wanted to do this. Oh, for fuck's sake.
This is like the world's strongest bottle.
I'm just gonna stand on it, because this is like not working.
I know, have you got like a hammer? This is just ridiculous. This is the world's strongest bottle. There we go. Right, we've also got some thumbtacks. Or drawing pins, if you're from the real world. So surely no tyres can survive this, the ultimate tyre gauntlet of death. Oh God. I think I've picked up a few pins. Yeah, there's definitely a few pins. I'm gonna go again. So there's a load of pins in the tires, but it's actually incredible because the tires are still completely inflated and they don't seem to have gone down much at all. There's a few marks of sealant, but I mean, they're still holding together, so I'm gonna ride over it a few more times. That's ridiculous. That's sealed as well. It's like war wounds. It's like I'm trying to kill it and it's an animal and it's bleeding. This is actually pretty incredible. There's loads of pieces of glass and you can probably see some of the drawing pins or thumbtacks actually embedded in the tyres, loads of them, but the tyre's still completely inflated. Everything is sealed, but I think I'm gonna take these pins out and see if it's able to seal all the holes once the pins are taken out. Oh, there's a bit of air coming out. Sealed. So fast. I can't believe it seals that fast. You can't hear the hissing of the air anymore. It's just done it, look. So not only have we used our homemade stinger, we've also put a load of drawing pins and glass through these tyres, repeatedly riding over them. And it's incredible, they've actually survived and they've sealed everything, and there's still plenty of air left in these tyres. You could easily ride home on them if you needed to, or if you were James Bond, you could escape the baddies successfully. So there you have it. Tubeless tyres are pretty indestructible.